Indonesia's YouTube Village Banks on Local Stars. Local mechanics love the easy-to-follow repair films, and neighbors are inspired as well. Until his unlikely turn to internet videos, Siswanto was a down on his luck mechanic in a small Java village. Banyumas, Indonesia, Siswanto was a down on his luck mechanic until an unlikely switch to internet videos transformed his neighbors into celebrities and catapulted his destitute farming village into the spotlight as Indonesia's YouTube village. The rags-to-riches story begins 4 years ago, when he was struggling to keep his auto repair company afloat in Kesegarin, a small Java town that most Indonesians would struggle to locate on a map. He was cash-strapped and in need of extra revenue to feed his growing family, but side jobs like salvaging rubbish and soybean farming weren't enough to make ends meet. After viewing a TV show about an Indonesian influencer who made a lot of money through internet videos, Siswanto decided to try releasing short comedy routines over Kesegarin's slow internet connection. But no one was watching them, so I stopped, said the 38-year-old, who goes by one name like many Indonesians. He believed it wasn't his destiny to earn a living that way until he was unable to fix a customer's expensive motorcycle and sought assistance from YouTube videos. Siswanto had an enlightenment and decided to create his own easy-to-follow fix-it films. The mechanic upgraded his phone, which he shared with his pregnant wife, and began filming non-stop. "I was shaking and talking gibberish," he claimed of his early videos, but Siswanto had amassed a following of more than 2 million YouTube followers after only a few years. Siswanto's burgeoning business, which he claims can bring in up to 150 million rupiah, $10,000, every month for his family, didn't go unnoticed in the community for long. Rumors circulated that the well-heeled mechanic was practicing black magic, and some parents forbade their children from entering his store for fear of being sacrificed to the evil arts. "So there was a sit-down in the village meeting hall," Siswanto explained, "and I explained that I have this YouTube business." To back up his deal, he offered free courses, and as a result, at least 30 others in Kesegarin have created their own YouTube channels, some with hundreds of thousands of subscribers. Kesegarin was able to purchase a faster internet connection with the extra funds, allowing students to take classes online after Indonesia shuttered schools to combat the coronavirus pandemic. "It's not an empty dream as long as you're willing to learn and work hard," Siswanto said.